AI is everywhere now, and honestly, it terrifies me. It's a job stealer. It's a killer of creativity. It's kind of soulless. And you probably feel the same way if you're watching this video. We're not to blame if we think that, because that's how it was marketed to us. But something's happened recently that's kind of shifted a lot of my perspective and attitude towards it, and it's kind of like a penny drop moment. It's been pretty huge for me. What if I could expand what I can offer within my own skill set? What happened next is really gonna blow your mind, but let me first rewind. I've been doing this for a very long time, and there are certain aspects to this job that makes it damaging or just hurtful, impossible in some instances. Firstly, there's a ceiling. No matter how hard you try, there's always going to be a limit to what you can produce in the time that you've got. Secondly, you're limited to what you have the potential to make. There's always a knowledge gap. You don't know everything. And there is definitely a knowledge gap for myself, and I know a lot of other people out there, between what they want to create and where they're at right now. That makes progress feel insurmountable. And thirdly, increasing your outputs to like appease your employer or to meet the expectations of a particular job, or in my case, you know, the audience, you guys watching this, like, can lead to really extreme burnout. I've experienced all of these, and deep down, I knew that the AI tools that everybody's been talking about online could have the capacity to fix those situations. But my challenge is, how do I use these ethically, meaningfully, so it's not just like wasting time, and without a huge knowledge gap that I have to overcome before I can get into it? And then it happened. I was introduced to INSTANCE.SO. INSTANCE is a platform where you can build pretty much anything code-based by instructing an AI as you go along. It's like briefing a developer to make your app and then iterating as you go along. You can build apps, games, like full-on multiplayer games, websites, Chrome extensions, pretty much any problem you have that can be solved with an app, you can make it yourself using INSTANCE. My mind started to explode. I could see all of my concerns that I've had with AI addressed with this one tool. Here's the plan. I'll build a series of rapid tools that will become services that will improve my business model and expand what I can offer. In my case, like as a content creator, that's what I do. And it's all gonna be documented in this video series, so stick around for it. It should start with building a website first. Something that I've been meaning to do, but my lack of knowledge with code has prevented me from doing this for many years. Once I've done that, I'm gonna move on to stuff that's more specific. Reporting tools, my own live stream alerts, stuff that I would normally pay for, but I can now build myself. Trend tools for targeted ideas for content creation, so I have a smarter, better idea of what I'm gonna be creating and what serves people watching my content. And I'll build on it a whole lot more as we go along. But let's take the first step.
The website. The first problem I need to solve is expanding my current library of existing video content into something more. So I've decided to create a website that functions as a blog, but with a whole lot more functionality. It's a blog that has a video input where I paste a video from my channel that I want to see a blog made out of. Then it will re-transcribe that video, screen grab some still frames of it, and compile a draft blog post, which I can go through and then edit before it goes live. It's still my content, it's just repurposed as a blog. It'll then embed the video for further SEO for the video, which is great, and then add my affiliate links to that product on the side. Boom, all of this without inputting any code. So now that I'm finished, let me walk you through it. If you're unfamiliar with INSTANCE, this panel on the left-hand side here is literally the chat. Here you'll input your inputs and then talk to the AI. And then this editor is very cool. It allows you to select certain parts of the project and then make prompts about that particular part or just manual edits. Very cool. Then you can also manipulate the code if you'd like. Above on the top of the screen, you've got preview and code, and you can do that straight up there. And you have access to all the different files. This is developed in React. And on the top right-hand side here, we've got download and publish. Download allows you to keep a local copy of the thing that you've just made, which is awesome. And publish allows you to put it out to a into the world, into a URL that's going to put it into the world. But for the sake of this video, I'm going to open up the website outside of the UI and kind of walk you through and take you on a journey as to how it works and everything. As you can see, it's pretty much a news blog with content. This is the last video that I've made. It's pretty straightforward, at least at least to the untrained eye. I don't know how to code, and I did this all without code, including the header, the social links, the contact pages, the about page, the shop page, everything. But my favorite part about this whole thing is this admin tab. So the admin tab is a tab that I'm going to be working on as I progress through this project. There's a couple of prerequisites I wanted. I wanted to see analytics. Here we go. It lands on the analytics page. This allows me to see the traffic, and I'm going to start putting more granular analytics as I go because it's going to help me get more brand deals and generate more work, right? Then on the post page, this is literally just like a regular post. You can do like a manual post over here, which I can create a title, blah, 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 and post it. Or I can import a video, which is the bulk reason I'm doing this. I need to expand my content into other realms without like having to have the discipline of sitting down and spending a couple of days transcribing and sorting it all out. It needs to happen automatically. I have to just get a YouTube URL. All I have to do is copy paste the URL. I actually like to just click the share one over here. And then I'm just going to copy paste that URL. I'm going to click directly import as a blog post. And status as a draft, you can choose to have it published or not. I can extract the information, download and process the transcript, capture video frames, and generate that blog content from my video that I've created. So here it is. It's over here in my timeline. If I click edit, this is the post. It's got a featured image that it's taken from the site already, from YouTube. It's embedded the video at the top of the page. But as you can see, the text that it pulls from the transcription isn't formatted nicely. There's like stuff like a tablet that's lowercase, and there are things in here that are probably going to be wrong, especially with text. So I've got a couple of solutions to it. So I've added some AI tools, including the replace word. So if I say a Redmi tablet and it goes red space me, I can replace that word. One of the problems I can see is that Redmi is in lowercase and so is Xiaomi. So what I'm going to do across the entire article is also replace article. So if it's Redmi, I'm going to replace it with Redmi, case sensitive, replace all. And then I'm also going to do the same thing with Xiaomi. So if it's Xiaomi, which is great. So that's the first thing for tech. It's super important for me to be able to do that without having to go through that whole transcript. I can also improve the text. And with one click, it is now used AI. See, the formatting has changed. It's added like an A tablet. There's a few things I want to do to improve it, but that is a huge deal. Obviously, I can go ahead and spend more time tweaking it. What I really do like, it has an alert at the top of the page that lets people know that it's pulled from a transcript of a video. Other button that I've included is optimize SEO. This is a tool that I've included to improve the discoverability of my videos, of my articles, finding out like where I can improve them. So the readability is really bad. I got to work that out. I might want to add a couple of things and add some tags and add some things to the content structure to improve it, which is great. So it's a great way to analyze the article instead of just like dumping the transcript and wishing it well. I can like just tweak it a little bit. I've also added a Grammarly plugin. This will help you edit in a way that, you know, improves the grammar of the whole thing. Okay, so I've tweaked it to how I would like it posted. I'm just going to change the status to public for you, published, and update and close this. Once I've finished the article, I can then go to this other panel called Sidebar Products. Now, this is really important for me. Here, I can add products that I've added to the shop and include them in my side panel on every single article. And those items are automatically generated to go through to the Amazon page and include my affiliate link, which is awesome. I'll show you a little bit about how I do that in a shortly. So let me, I haven't added this product yet, but I have added another related product. I'm gonna add a couple of these. Okay, great. Pulled the whole thumbnail as the title. It's got all the featured text and looks beautiful. You click on the article. Article is formatted beautifully. And here are the recommended products on the right-hand side, which is awesome. And these will link through to the Amazon listing. And this is what the article looks like. If I could spend more time tweaking it to make sure that there's better SEO. But that is pretty ridiculous. I can also share and copy this link. But that's huge. That has saved me hours and hours and hours of work in one go. And that's just the content that's populating the page. Let's go through to the shop. So the shop is a space that I created with the AI. And I say that because this is one of my favorite parts about working with Instance, is that when you code something, but manually by hand. You've got to have a really strong roadmap of what you're going to be building. Any deviation from that is going to like topple the house of cards or the toothpicks that you put together. The AI helped me build this page and the system on its own from a prompt in a language because the actual product doesn't exist. There was no plugin that it could build for it. And it gave me a whole bunch of really cool ideas afterwards. So we now have a shop, which is awesome. It's got the embeds and the articles that are linked to that shop. I can still add products in the future that are not listed on Amazon. If I've got other affiliate programs that I'm a part of, I can add them here. And in the settings tab, we can change stuff like what's happening on the about page and on the contact page, obviously. And then we can also change stuff that's happening on the shop page. And this is a tool that I want to iterate and improve on as I go along with this, because there's so many different ways I can use this to generate funds passively. Like, it could be the hub of where I get my affiliate links from, number one. And number two, it's going to generate traffic on its own because of that SEO and deliver people to content about the product that they want to purchase that I've created as a video, and then convert them potentially into customers and then generate affiliate revenue for me so I can make commission on the sales of these products, which is huge. And this is a way that AI is helping me expand my business, and I'm in love with it. There's no Swiss Army knife for success, and there's no Swiss Army knife to do something where you theoretically never have to work. I don't think that's firstly ethical, and secondly, I don't think that's even a possibility. But having the vision to create something out of these brand new tools that are being developed, like INSTANCE.SO, to create something that's going to help you improve your business with the work that you're currently doing is up to your vision. And you have vision to apply to this. And I'm really excited to see and hear what people, please let me know in the comments what you end up doing with something like this and a service like this. The second part of this is I am going to be doing a video series where I add tools to my arsenal to improve my business as it stands using this tool. I can't wait to show you some of the ideas that I have. So make sure that you subscribe for that, please. You're going to want to see what we're building. It's going to hopefully change your whole idea and mindset on how you can use INSTANCE.SO to improve your current business. The snippets I've shown friends, their minds have exploded. I hope you've enjoyed this. I'm going to see you in the next one. Cheers.